Hi folks, I thought I'd show you some stuff before we go outside. I'm going to make an alteration to my weight training bench, which has been sitting around the back for quite a long time. We're going to make a new bench part, the top part for it, because it's all rotten and stuff. So anyway, let's show you this stuff first. Right, well, I've had these little cards here sent to me. I'll just read the letter out for you. It says, "Hi Martin, please find enclosed a variety of vehicles for your restoration channel. The bus needs some soldering and the Tippex removing. Not sure if the James Bond car should have a roof. Keep up the great work." And that comes from Nick Walton. Thank you very much, Nick. Now, Nick sent me a little selection of cars here. Let's show you them. So as you can see, there's an old bus there. This is what he was talking about. It looks like it's been painted with Tippex. It's got some broken bits on the front there, as you can see, which, as he mentioned, will probably need soldering. And this is a, what is it? Corgi Major. They've normally got the years on them. I can't actually see the years on it, but it's not got the wheels on it either. But yeah, that's in a right old state, that is. So that's one of them. There's a little Lesney removal van there. What is this? It's a Pickford removal van, so it doesn't say the date on that one. I thought they all did, but that's in the right old state. And again, it's got a bit of broken window pillar at the front there. There's the James Bond car I was mentioning. I think these are supposed to have a roof on them. It's still got the ejector seat in it, which you can probably see there. And also, James Bond is still sitting in there, but again, it's in a bit of a state where, again, there'll be no tyres on. There's a couple of small Land Rovers or Range Rovers. That one, again, has got a wheel missing. Yep. You can buy all these wheels, so I'm going to have to source parts for these before I actually do refurbish them. And there's a couple of fire engines there from, again, different eras, I would imagine. And, yeah, so that's very nice. So they'll be coming up sometime on the Restoration Channel. Probably Retro Hacks, maybe on Retro Restore, as I've got a die-cast column on there. And I might do them on there. So let's drive them over to the side. I'll put them away. And this is what I've been restoring on Retro Hacks on this week coming out today. You probably don't know this, but I'll give you a little sneak peek. This is actually one of the things, again, which was sent in by a subscriber, and I've actually restored it now. Let's give you a closer look at it. This is a Tonka Mighty Loader, and this was in the right old state actually when I got it. So I'm hoping you can see that it's in really nice condition now. Everything's back as it was. Just take you around the other side to it. Do a little turn around there. And yeah, I'm really happy with the way it's come out. I've literally just got hold of the tool that puts the rivets in, and that finishes the job off rather than normal using normal rivets. And I've also managed to get some of the cap wheel trim retainers. And I've got one of my other subscribers from America is actually sending me a job lot of them as well. So I'm really thankful for that. But as you can see, this has been powder coated and it's come out absolutely lovely. And as you can see, it's Tonka there. And yeah, I'm well pleased with the way that's turned out. So you're getting a little preview of this. It's not out yet. It may be out by the time this video goes up. But yeah, the graphics I made myself. Again, there, water slide transfers on there. And I then printed out on my laser printer. So you can buy these sort of stickers, but I prefer to make my own. So yeah, there you go. It's a lovely old tool. And that will probably end up on display somewhere. It's all fully functional. And as you can see there, it's got a movable shovel at the front as well. So there you go. That will be on Retro Hacks channel, probably by the time this video goes out as well. Right, let's go outside. I'll show you my weight training bench. But before I do that, I'll just tell you about the Triumph Acclaim bits. I've got this over here, look. Both of the undersides of the bumpers have been repaired now and painted and sealed. I've just got to sort the surface out, but I've been very, very busy at the moment. I've got all the bearings and stuff over here, all awaiting installation, and including the bearings as well for the wheel hubs. This was, as you probably know, the old bearing race there, which goes into the actual wheel hub itself. And I've actually gone out and bought a bearing press kit, because as you know, I've powder coated the control arms, and as a result of that, I don't really want to damage them by hitting them. Although I got the old bearings out by hitting them, but because they've all been freshly painted, I thought I'd pull them, buy the proper kit to pull them in nicely. So let me quickly show you that before we look out at my weight training bench. Oh, that was it. I forgot one other thing I've got to show you as well. Again, I've got some really nice subscribers out there. And I got this pair of Media Blasting cabinet gloves from one of my subscribers. And he writes, "Hi Martin and Co. Gloves as promised. I hope they fit. And if they do, I think they should last a good while. Thank you very much for your channels. I've been watching some of your older videos. Your Tracy seems to have the same rapport with you as my girl. And Jimmy and Sharon are definitely like my son and his mum. So similar, it's uncanny. Thanks again." That's from Hugh Bell. Thanks very much, Hugh. As I say, he bought these, but they was too small for his cabinet. And he looks at mine and he thinks they should probably fit mine. And I think they will as well, looking at them. So I'm hoping that's the case. As you know, my gloves, the ones I've got on my cabinet, I've had for a good few years now. So he kindly donated them to my channel as well. So thanks very much, Hugh. That's greatly appreciated, bud. Right, now let's go outside. Right, so this is a set I've just literally bought and I was waiting for it to come. That's why I've not actually done the Triumph yet. Is that the right way up? Yeah, let's open it up. So I've just gone out and bought this, and it's a wheel bearing removal kit. And as I say, it's got a host of different adapters in there and things for all different sorts of wheel bearings. So I'm hoping that's going to do the job. And hopefully in the future, make my life a lot easier as well. You can use this to put bearings in and also take them out as well. But as you can see there, it's quite complex and it wasn't too bad actually. It's about 35, 40 pounds. And hopefully that should last a good few years. Right, so this is it. I've had this out here. Back of the garden literally for absolutely years and years, and it seemed better days to be honest with you, but now I've lost over, well, about 2.5 stone in weight. I'm coming back baby. Here she is. There's Sharon. You're gonna help me with this, aren't you, baby?
Yeah,
talk a bit louder.
Yeah.
Hey,
I'm gonna cover it for you.
Right, so let's have a closer look at it.
Not that I use it.
No, you won't be using it, baby.
Oh, no.
But I'm gonna be using it because I'm coming back, baby. I'm turning the clock back. So let's have a closer look at what we've actually got to do here. The wood itself is actually rotten. The fixings are broken. Let me bring you nearer. Right, turn it over then, shall? So as you can see, look, it's only made up of like plywood there and some foam there. Now that foam obviously has been out in all weathers and it had green mould on it. So you've ordered some new foam, haven't you?
Yeah, that should be in a week.
Right. So we've got some coverage, haven't we?
We've got nice red coverage for you.
Right. So that is that, and also this. This one's still fixed on, but we've got to take that off. And what I said I'd do, we got some spare wood. I said I'd make this up again, because you need the fixings actually on this, and they've all rotted away, you see. So I've got to make some sort of fixings where we can fix through these rods here. Now, again, I might take this apart and see if I can sandblast it as well. I don't know whether it's painted or sandblasted or whatever, I can't remember. I'll have a look at it anyway, but...
it's rusty here, look.
Yeah, I know it's rusty, but I mean, if I can't sandblast it, I may just paint over it again, I'm not sure. So that's what we're going to do. So first of all, I've got to get a bit of wood and measure the size of it and then cut it for you ready to staple all your material and cloth on. Is that all right?
Yep.
You happy with that?
I'm over the moon with that.
Happy days. So let's just lay that on there for the moment, baby. Like that. That's how it's going to be. Right. So we've only got 20 kilograms here. It's not a lot of weight, yeah? Let's put that on there like that. Hey, let's put that on there like that, baby. I used to spend my life in the gym many years ago, as you well know. Ugh. Let's get my head down there. Oh, put my feet like that. Hey. Now, a lot of people, let me just remind you that I actually, back in 1992 or 93, I was a qualified fitness instructor. I know exactly what I'm doing. All right? Oh, got an itch. Up. It's nice and light anyway. And then down above the chest and push up. One, two, three. All under control. Down in control. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Nice and easy. Back onto there. I should have had you behind me, Sharon. Spotting me. No, spotting me. It's called spotting when you stand behind someone, yeah? So look, see, I can't do it with that bench here. Look at that, look.
Dangerous.
Unbelievable. So as a lot of them won't know, Sharon, from the age of about 17, or ever since I've known you, which was a hell of a long time ago, up until I left full-time employment, probably about 2005, although I did go to a gym after that, didn't I?
Mm.
I still did attend the gym, but nowhere near regular as what I used to do. And that's when I put on over 3 stone in weight, and 2 stone of that is now gone now. I'm actually, the weight now, I'm 15 stone basically. I was at my highest last year was 17 stone 10. So I've dropped 2.5 stone in that time, I suppose, or 2 stone 10, something like that. And I'm going to lose another couple of stone as well. So that's what I'm going to do, baby. And you're doing very well as well. So that's what we're doing. And my plan was to get healthy first and then to get fit. So I'm a lot more healthy than what I was. And as I say, the diabetes is fully under control now. All done with diet. I'm still vegetarian. I'm still carb free and I'm still dairy free. And I basically eat a lot of food, don't I, baby?
Oh, you do.
Unbelievable amount of food. Sharon don't really eat a lot. She's like a little bleeding bird, isn't you? She's
so,
my little bird. Anyway, I'm going to get this sorted out, Sharon. I'll take this off of there for you. Curling, look, I used to curl, what's this, 20 kilograms? I used to curl at my best.
Is that a sack of potatoes?
What is? 25 kilograms is a bag of potatoes. Mm. But when I used to curl with the dumbbell or the barbell like this, I used to curl with a 50 kilogram barbell like this. Like, down like that, baby. Like that. Yeah, just slightly bend your knees. And then bring it up to there and then control down, straight arm, and then bring it back up and then back down again. A lot of people, you'll see down the gym, they do that. No, full length, like that, and then bring it back up again like that. Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm not teaching you, baby. I know you're not interested. And that's it. So we're going to work on this. We can't do it right at this moment because...
The foam's not here.
The foam's not here. Right, so that's what we're going to be doing. Next time, hopefully, you see this.
Well, you've got a chance to sandblast it, then, haven't you? While you wait for the foam.
Yeah, I'm going to try to sandblast it. Hopefully, you'll be seeing the triumph. Oh, pardon me. Come over here, baby. She's gone behind the camera. She's directing.
I'm happy behind the camera.
No, you're not.
I am.
Are you?
Yeah, that might be in front of the camera.
No, you don't. There. So, hopefully, there should be a triumph for claim video this week. What was the other thing I was doing? Your lawnmower. Someone asked about your lawnmower.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I've been waiting on that because I've got to do the graphics for it before I can lacquer it, before I can put it all back together. And as I say, that Tonka truck, I've been working quite a lot on that over this last week or so. So, yeah, that's what we're up to at the moment. Just a little quick fast blast one, this one. So I'll be working on this and maybe put some training little videos sometime on Butler's Empire throughout the year, or definitely when I get this sorted out. The weather's lovely out here at the moment, baby, isn't it?
It's actually warmer outside than in our house, isn't
it? Yeah, I know. Anyway, well, thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoy this channel. Don't forget to rate, comment and subscribe. Rate means put your thumbs up or thumbs down, whatever you want to do. And we'll see you again in the next video. And until then,
au revoir.
Bye for now.